Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn what is power over Ethernet technology, which is also commonly known as a PoE. And we will also see some standards which are used for this power over Ethernet technology. Now, as we know, Ethernet is the networking protocol which is used to establish the local area network or a LAN. And data is carried using the network cables or a Ethernet cables. Now in PoE or power over Ethernet technology, along with the data, power can also be carried on these Ethernet cables, and using this, different network devices can be powered up. So now generally the network device which require less power are powered up using this power over Ethernet technology. So the IP phone, wireless router and the IP cameras are the example of the network devices which can be powered up using this power over Ethernet technology. And today, if you see, this power over Ethernet technology is so established that millions of devices in the world are powered up using this technology. Now, there are several advantages of using this power over Ethernet technology. Firstly, you don't require additional wires to power up these network devices. And second, you can also install these network devices to the inaccessible locations where it is difficult to provide the power supply. So using this power over Ethernet technology, it is possible to maximize the saving on the installation cost. Now there are several techniques for transferring the power over these Ethernet cables, which are defined under some IEEE standards. And here is the list of the IEEE standards which are commonly used for transferring the power over these Ethernet cables. Now under these standards, several things are defined, like how much maximum power can be transferred over these Ethernet cables, what should be the length of the cable over which we can safely transfer the data, or what should be the maximum voltage or current which can be applied over these Ethernet cables. So now before we see about the standards, let us first of all understand some basic PoE terminologies. So the equipment which supplies the power to the network devices is known as the power source equipment or a PSE, and the network devices which receives the power over the Ethernet cables are known as the power devices. So now before supplying the power to these network devices, the first thing that PSE check is whether these devices are PoE enabled or not. And to check that, this PSE sends the signals in form of voltage to these power devices. And in response, it receives the signature of these power devices, which is nothing but the resistance across these power devices. Now every power device have some internal resistance which is isolated from the main circuitry. And once the signature detection procedure gets completed, and if power device is eligible to receive the power from the PSE, then actual circuit will get exposed to this power source equipment. So now if the resistance that is detected by this PSE is in the range of 19 kilo ohm and 25 kilo ohm, then this power device is eligible to receive the power from this power source equipment. And if this resistance is less than 15 kilo ohm or greater than 33 kilo ohm, then this PSE will not supply power to this power devices. That means this power device is not eligible to receive the power from the power source equipment. So now this entire signaling procedure for detecting the resistance across this power device is known as the resistive power discovery. Now the entire signaling procedure is defined under this IEEE 802.3.AF standard. So now once this procedure gets completed, the PSE finds out how much power is required by the power device. And to find that, it applies a specific voltage to the power device. And in the response, it receives the current that is flowing through this power device. So in this way, the power source equipment decides how much power should get supplied to this power device. So under IEEE 802.3.AF, the maximum power which can be supplied by this PSE is 15.4 watt, and the maximum power which can be received by the power device is 12.95 watt. And obviously the received power will be less compared to the supplied power, because some of the power will get lost across the cable resistance. So now let us find out how this PoE enabled network switch is connected to the power devices like IP camera using this Ethernet cable. So now if the network switch is PoE enabled, then we can directly connect this power source equipment with this power device like a IP camera. So if the switch is PoE enabled, or in another words, if it cannot supply the power to the power devices, then you will require the another device which is known as the midspan. So this midspan adds the PoE capability to the standard networking switch. And if you see the wiring arrangement of the Ethernet cable, it will look like this. So the data pairs will go as it is, and power is supplied by this midspan over the spare pairs. So now if you don't know about the Ethernet cable wiring, the Ethernet cable has a 8 number of wires. And under the 10 base T and the 100 base T networks, out of these 8 wires, only 4 wires or 2 twisted pairs are used for the data communication, and 4 wires remains as a spare. While in the case of a 1000 base T network or a gigabit Ethernet network, all the 4 pairs are used for the data communication. So now there are 2 possibilities or 2 different types in which we can provide the power over this Ethernet cable. The first method is known as the type B or a alternative B method, in which power is supplied over the spare pairs of this Ethernet cable. While in case of a type A or alternative A method, the power is supplied on the same pairs over which the data is carried. And this technique is known as the phantom power fit technique. So now, as I said earlier, 3 different standards exist for this power over Ethernet technology. So now we have already discussed about this first standard, that is IEEE 802.3.af, over which the maximum power which can be supplied by the PAC is 15.4 watt. While if you see the second standard, which is also known as the PoE plus, over which the maximum power which can be supplied by the PAC equipment is 30 watt. While if you see the third standard can support up to maximum 100 watt of power at a PAC end. But this standard is still under the development phase, and this standard can be used for the gigabit Ethernet network. So as I said earlier, in the gigabit Ethernet, all the 4 pairs are used for the data transmission. So under this standard, the power will be carried on the all the 4 pairs of the Ethernet cable. And as all the 4 pairs are used for the power transfer, the maximum power which can be delivered across the power devices will be also more. So now, once the devices over this standard will be commercially available, we can use them to power up not only the IP cameras but even the LED bulbs at our house or at our offices. Or maybe it can be used to power up the POS terminals at the billing counters of the shopping malls. So these are the different classes of the power that is supported by these 3 different standards. And according to the standard that is supported by these power devices are classified under the 4 different types. And here is the complete list of the different properties of a E-standard, like what should be the maximum voltage, what should be the maximum current, what should be the maximum cable resistance, and many other things under particular standard. So I hope in this video you understood what is power over Ethernet technology. So if you have any question or suggestion, please let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.